The solid earth is made of rocks, which are made of minerals. To understand rocks, you need to become familiar with minerals and how they are identified. This outcome gives you the background needed to understand the terms used in identifying minerals. This section will introduce you to minerals. You will learn the various techniques used by geologists to identify and classify minerals. Physical characteristics of minerals. What are minerals? All rocks except obsidian and coal are made of minerals. Obsidian is a volcanic rock made of glass and coal is made of organic carbon. Most rocks contain several minerals in a mixture characteristic of the particular rock type. When identifying a rock, you must first identify the individual minerals that make up that rock. Minerals are naturally occurring, inorganic solids with a definite chemical composition and a crystal lattice structure. Although thousands of minerals in the Earth have been identified, just 10 minerals make up most of the volume of the Earth's crust: plagioclase, quartz, orthoclase, amphibole, pyroxene, olivine, calcite, biotite, garnet, and clay. Together, the chemical formula, the types and proportions of the chemical elements, and the crystal lattice, the geometry of how the atoms are arranged and bonded together, determine the physical properties of minerals. The chemical formula and crystal lattice of a mineral can only be determined in a laboratory, but by examining a mineral and determining several of its physical properties, you can identify the mineral. First, you need to become familiar with the physical properties of minerals and how to recognize them. Minerals can be identified by their physical characteristics. The physical properties of minerals are related to their chemical composition and bonding. Some characteristics, such as a mineral's hardness, are more useful for mineral identification. Color is readily observable and certainly obvious, but it is usually less reliable than other physical properties. How are minerals identified? Figure 1. This mineral has shiny, gold, cubic crystals with striations, so it is pyrite. Figure 1. This mineral has shiny, gold, cubic crystals with striations, so it is pyrite. Mineralogists are scientists who study minerals. One of the things mineralogists must do is identify and categorize minerals. While a mineralogist might use a high-powered microscope to identify some minerals, most are recognizable using physical properties. Check out the mineral in Figure 1. What is the mineral's color? What is its shape? Are the individual crystals shiny or dull? Are there lines, striations, running across the minerals? Color, streak, and luster. Diamonds are popular gemstones because the way they reflect light makes them very sparkly. Turquoise is prized for its striking greenish-blue color. Notice that specific terms are being used to describe the appearance of minerals. Color. Figure 2. This mineral is shiny, very soft, heavy, and gold in color, and is actually gold. Color is often useful, but should not be relied upon. Different minerals may be the same color. Real gold, as seen in Figure 2, is very similar in color to the pyrite in Figure 1. Additionally, some minerals come in many different colors. Quartz, for example, may be clear, white, gray, brown, yellow, pink, red, or orange. So color can help, but do not rely on color as the determining property. Figure 3 shows one sample of quartz that is colorless and another quartz that is purple. A tiny amount of iron makes the quartz purple. Many minerals are colored by chemical impurities,